researchers have found an effective new method for removing carbon dioxide from the ocean. As carbon dioxide continues to build up in the Earth's atmosphere, research teams around the world have spent years seeking ways to remove the gas efficiently from the air. Meanwhile, the world's number one sink for carbon dioxide from the atmosphere is the ocean, which soaks up some 30-40% of all of the gas produced by human activities. Recently, the possibility of removing carbon dioxide directly from ocean water has emerged as another promising possibility for mitigating CO2 emissions, one that could potentially someday even lead to overall net negative emissions. But like air capture systems, the idea has not yet led to any widespread use, though there are a few companies attempting to enter this area. Now, a team of researchers at MIT says they may have found the key to a truly efficient and inexpensive removal mechanism. The findings were reported in the journal Energy and Environmental Science in a paper by MIT professors. The existing methods for removing carbon dioxide from seawater apply a voltage across a stack of membranes to acidify a feed stream by water splitting. This converts bicarbonates in the water to molecules of CO2, which can then be removed under vacuum. The membranes are expensive, and the chemicals are required to drive the overall electrode reactions at either end of the stack, adding further to the expense and the complexity of the processes. The researchers wanted to avoid the need for introducing chemicals to the anode and cathode half cells, and to avoid the use of membranes if at all possible. The team came up with a reversible process consisting of membrane-free electrochemical cells. Reactive electrodes are used to release protons to the seawater fed to the cells, driving the release of the dissolved carbon dioxide from the water. The process is cyclic. It first acidifies the water to convert dissolved inorganic bicarbonates to molecular carbon dioxide, which is collected as a gas under vacuum. Then the water is fed to a second set of cells with a reversed voltage to recover the protons and turn the acidic water back to alkaline before releasing it back to the sea. Periodically, the roles of the two cells are reversed once one set of electrodes is depleted of protons during acidification and the other has been regenerated during alkalinization. This removal of carbon dioxide and re-injection of alkaline water could slowly start to reverse, at least locally, the acidification of oceans that has been caused by carbon dioxide buildup, which in turn has threatened coral reefs and shellfish. The re-injection of alkaline water could be done through dispersed outlets or far offshore to avoid a local spike of alkalinity that could disturb ecosystems. Once the carbon dioxide is removed from the water, it still needs to be disposed of, as with other carbon removal processes. For example, it can be buried in deep geologic formations under the sea floor, or it can be chemically converted into a compound like ethanol, which can be used as a transportation fuel, or into other specialty chemicals. Initially, at least, the idea would be to couple such systems with existing or planned infrastructure that already processes seawater, such as desalination plants. The system could also be implemented by ships that would process water as they travel, in order to help mitigate the significant contribution of ship traffic to overall emissions. There are already international mandates to lower shipping's emissions, and this could help shipping companies to offset some of their emissions and turn ships into ocean scrubbers. The system could also be implemented at locations such as offshore drilling platforms or at aquaculture farms. Eventually, it could lead to a deployment of freestanding carbon removal plants distributed globally. The process could be more efficient than air capture systems because the concentration of carbon dioxide in seawater is more than 100 times greater than it is in air. In direct air capture systems, it is first necessary to capture and concentrate the gas before recovering it. The oceans are large carbon sinks, so there is no capture step. That means the volumes of material that need to be handled are much smaller, potentially simplifying the whole process and reducing the footprint requirements. The research is continuing, with one goal being to find an alternative to the present step that requires a vacuum to remove the separated carbon dioxide from the water. Another need is to identify operating strategies to prevent precipitation of minerals that can foul the electrodes in the alkalinization cell, an inherent issue that reduces the overall efficiency in all reported approaches. The team expects that the system could be ready for a practical demonstration project within about 2 years.